Representatives for the class of 2024, we have Olivia Church and Ike Rouser. We also have attendance DeMica Smith and Anthony Delane. Now let's find out who the king and queen are as voted on by the student body. The moment you've all been waiting for. The Lorain High homecoming queen for the fall of 2023 is DeMica Smith. And the Lorain High homecoming king for the fall of 2023 is Ike Rouser. Again, thank you to all those who participated, and let's have a round of applause for our king and queen, DeMica Smith and Ike Rouser. And assigned according to procedures adopted by the Ohio High School Athletic Association and Lake Erie League Conference. The officials for tonight's game are umpire Marlo Sams, back judge John Govich, head linesman Sid Mackinnon, line judge Troy Bryant, and referee Thomas Cooney. Ladies and gentlemen, the Shaw Cardinals. Thank you. George Daniel Field on Oberlin Avenue in Lorain, Ohio. Good Friday evening, everyone, and welcome to a very special sports presentation on WLCS-TV 20, Lorain City Schools Television. Tonight, Week 8 high school football action. And boy, the first 7 weeks have gone very well for the Lorain High Titans. 6-1 coming into tonight's ballgame as they take on the Shaw Cardinals here at George Daniel Field. Great to have you with us, and I am thrilled to be here in the broadcast booth at George Daniel Field with my two of my longtime friends with Lorain City Schools and Lorain Sports. To my immediate left, one Tom Bauer, and down a little bit further to T-Bone's immediate left is one Jay Ferguson. Now, this is my first chance, guys, to have a look at the Lorain High Titans, but as I said, they are 6-1. You guys have seen this football team. To what do we owe the success? Tom, we'll start with you.
They had a running game that was very successful, but in the recent games, they're starting to pick up their passing now. So I think they're working till the end of the season, because I'm thinking the next two games after this one will be for the conference championship. They got Bedford, and then they got Maple, and they're going to have to work on their passing and their running, because teams can shut down their running with eight men in the box.
Jay, you've seen this team a lot.
I've been around this team, and you know the word I use is trust. The first thing that happened is Jeff Graham and administration trusted the process with Damian Creel. and it was a process. And you know, Damien, first off, they're 17 seconds away from being 7-0. But last week at a booster club meeting, he came in, and he wasn't talking about his record. He was waving around grade reports and talking about how many kids he had on the honor roll. And that, when I say trust and the process, that's the process that he has brought to this sideline.
So Lorain looking for win number 7 tonight as they host the Shaw Cardinals. And for Shaw, as our cameras will pick up throughout the night, this is a very shorthanded Shaw Cardinal football team. Not a lot of guys dressed, so we'll see how this plays out as Shaw comes into tonight's ball game at 0-6. So, guys, before we get started, we should also mention this is the finale for Joe Bock. B-O-C-K calls it an E-N-D tonight.
Again.
Amazing.
Again.
Oh, come on now. No, so
hey,
I'm
nobody's worse
here.
At retiring than me.
So Lorain will have it first, and the Titans will receive the kick, go right to left. And, boy, how about the weather gods cooperating with us? Goodness.
Beautiful night for football, isn't it? Yeah.
If you had heard the forecast or saw the forecast last night, you would have thought we would have been sitting here in a monsoon right off the shores of Lake Erie. But as Jay said, just a perfect night for football. On the return is Toriano Allen for Lorain, and the Titans will have it at their own 35-yard line to get things started.
I tell you, Jamar Davis for Shaw had a nice open field tackle there. You got to give them a little bit of credit. Short-handed like they are, they're still going to play football.
Tom, as you mentioned, Lorain High so far this year has really utilized that ground game, and it's led by John Solomon, Sr., who coming into tonight, 926 yards, averaging 7.5 yards per carry.
Yes, yeah.
And 3 touchdowns away from this, tying the school record.
Got 12 TDs this season. Lorain's quarterback, Chase Davis, a junior coming into tonight, hasn't thrown a lot of passes, but he's been very consistent, completing just under 61%. He's got 3 touchdown passes on the year.
Yeah, and I think his working the passing game as it progresses is giving him more and more confidence. That's what I've seen in the last couple games.
Inside handoff, Solomon gets to the 40, now cuts back to the middle, 45, 50, look out! On the first play of the game, John Solomon's going to take it to the house, 65 yards. And on the very first play from the line of scrimmage, it is Lorain High bursting out to a 6-0 lead. That is touchdown number 13 on the year for John Solomon.
Wow.
Well, that's how you like to start, Tim. Yeah. And, you know, what you saw there on that play was the growth of John Solomon, the runner. Look at the patience here as he hides behind one of the pulling guards. Look.
But, you know, you got to give that guard a lot. He's still blocking.
Yep.
Who, that 68?
Yeah, Shane Ramey Rowland.
Yeah. Yep. Mm-hmm.
Shane Ramey Rowland, as you said, Tom, continued with the block. And Solomon with the 65-yard run, 18 seconds into the ball game.
John Solomon, over 1,000.
There you go. Right.
And here's another plus to their program. Reggie Johnson has been a gifted kicker for them. He's on a soccer team. He does well on the soccer team, but he has kicked. I don't know how many extra points he's missed, like 1 or 2?
I think 2.
2 extra points, made a couple of field goals. Things they lacked a few years ago, now they have a kicker.
So a rapid-fire start for Lorain High as on the first play, John Solomon goes 65 yards. Now, Jay, I was given a number of 926.
I heard 946, so you could be right.
Well, that's the number I have.
Okay.
But he's close. He's at 991 after that. But again, what a remarkable season that Solomon has put together.
You know, we've been talking about John Solomon, but I said this the very first game. I've coached long enough to know you can't just depend on a tailback. You depend on those mules up front. And if you don't have the blocking, you don't have the running back. And I give them a lot of credit.
4 seniors in that line.
Yeah, give them a lot of credit.
So a very quick 7-0 lead for Lorain High. And now the Titans will kick off in the Shaw Cardinals, as we mentioned. And it certainly isn't anything to impugn their program. They just have low numbers tonight. So trying to get things built under head coach Reggie Smith. There's an end-over-end kick. Will bounce at the 5 and go into the end zone. That'll be a touchback. So Shaw will have it first down and 10. Just a gorgeous night here in the city of Lorain. Flag basically still down to our left in front of the beautiful scoreboard. Couldn't have asked for a better Friday night.
I did look at the forecast last night, and I was worried about bringing raincoats. Yeah. And are we going to be able to make it? Yeah.
Yep.
See, that's another why we do sports and not weather. I do not have, nor do I ever want to have, the American Meteorological Society seal of approval.
Right.
You know, we talked about their running game and passing game improving, but this defense have also improved.
Trayvon Roscoe is the Shaw quarterback. He's a senior. So Roscoe will direct traffic for the Cardinals. Starting this drive at their own 20-yard line.
Seems to be some confusion on the Titan bench.
We're going to spot him and only play with 11, I think.
And now David Whitaker comes out onto the field. Well, now he comes back. Manny Rosario will step in for Lorain. So now the lineups are set, and here we go. First play for Shaw, and they're already down 7-0. Got 11:42 to go here in the first quarter of play. Again, Trayvon Roscoe is the Cardinal quarterback. Hands off. A little bit of a dart move there by Jamarian Parks. And Parks with a nice carry out over the 25 to about the 28-yard line.
It should be noted that they came in here last year, the last game of the season, at 1-8. And it was 14-7 at halftime.
Yeah.
I mean, Lorain prevailed. But Shaw made a game of it. Now, their numbers are obviously down.
But they've always had athletes. One thing I always said about Shaw is the athletes they could put on the field.
Here we see a 3-wide to the right formation with a single receiver to the left by himself in the backfield is Roscoe.
There comes an end.
Now you got somebody coming late onto the field. Flags will fly. Roscoe's going to run it himself. Picks up the first down, but that'll come back. As you saw, Shaw had a player running onto the field.
And it was just a matter of whether it was going to be that or they were going to not have enough guys on the line, because that receiver was definitely in the backfield, as you said.
Yeah. Yeah.
So there's a situation where Shaw shoots themselves in the foot. They had a second down and short. And now 2nd and 6 as the ball goes back to the 24-yard line. Jay, I want to go back to a comment you mentioned earlier about Coach Creel and the job he has done now in his third year and building this program step by step, piece by piece, putting all the building blocks in place. We'll talk more about that after this second down play. 2nd and 6 from the 24-yard line. Now we've got a 4-receiver look to the right with a single receiver to the left. And it's Trayvon Roscoe, the quarterback, who awaits the snap, looking for some room to run. Bounces outside, got to the 30, picked up the first down, and chugs out of bounds at about the 33-yard line. Well, you guys have both been involved in coaching, but Jay, I'll let you start in regards to Coach Creel and what he's done to build this program step by step, as you called it, a process.
Well, number one is he had communication, a lot of communication with Dave McFarland. And, you know, Coach Creel realized I have to get kids to believe in me and trust me before I can get a performance on the football field. So he set up shop the first year knowing that the on-the-field product was going to suffer after COVID, but determined that he was going to have kids do things the right way. Just little things like shake your hand and look you in the eye. Take your hat off when you come into a room. Just little things like that. And that kind of discipline has carried over.
That was Zaire Chaney, on an end around. He had lined up wide to the left. Here's the replay. And Zaire Chaney with a nice gain as he broke a tackle there and got out to about the 38-yard line. Tom, we'll get your thoughts on Coach Creel and the job of building this program after this second down play. Shaw needs to get to the 43. This is their first possession of the night. As Roscoe looks, throws, and he threw it by his intended receiver at the 45-yard line. He was trying to zip that one in to LaShawn Clark. But, Tom, you've been around coaching a long time and around some outstanding coaches. Talk about building that trust factor.
Well, you know, Jay talked about the trust factor and what he's done in school and what he's done there. I've been to a few of his practices, and they are well organized. Everyone is doing something. Kids are always working. And that's what I attribute a lot of his success to, is how he handles practicing.
Great point.
Yeah, on the field.
And you play how you practice.
Yeah, exactly.
Third and five from the 38-yard line. Here's Roscoe rolling, throwing, and he short hopped that one to his intended receiver. As not quite able to come up with that. He may have had some room to run. I believe it was Trayron Axon.
I'm looking for them to come back with that quads on one side. Lorain overloads that, and he'll go back weak side again. That will come back in the future to maybe haunt Lorain.
Well, they're going to go. I mean, one of the things when you're short numbers, you got to worry about punt snaps, and I don't see a punter out there.
So their own 38-yard line, now they got Jamarian Parks to punt. So after picking up a first down and having a second and short, the drive stalls for Shaw.
Oh, there it is. Okay.
Well,
8:49 to go, first quarter. As they get the kick away, but boy, that's a shanked short kick. Finally rolls dead at the 49-yard line. That'll be an 11-yard punt. So you're going to put this Lorain offense on the Shaw side of the 50. First down and 10.
You know, that's one of the things that's a problem a lot of times with short-handed numbers.
Specialists, yeah.
Is getting your specialties run.
So first and 10 for Lorain. They scored on their only play from the line of scrimmage. As on the very first play of the ball game, John Solomon raced 65 yards for a score. That's where we are, 7-0. Lorain High in the lead, and now Chase Davis will take the snap out of that pistol formation. Here comes Solomon. Again, a lot of room to run. Breaks to the left sideline and dropped at the 35. Now there, Jay Ferguson, is the run that puts him over 1,000 yards for the year. Boy, what a season John Solomon has had. And it's only week 8. He's got 2 more games after tonight and on to postseason.
And his shoulder is really banged up. You know, I'm sure he's going to get a few carries and get out of here tonight.
Davis looks right, throws right, complete. Nice gainer there, is on the move. Iro Williams, and Williams all the way down inside the 15, dropped at about the 12-yard line of Shaw. So 3 huge plays from Lorain offensively. The first play, the touchdown, and now 2 plays on this drive have ripped off big yardage.
Yeah, Hiro has become one of their go-to receivers. I think he's leading, and he's in the statistics for the county as a, you know, not top because we don't throw that much.
Oh, no.
And now we've got an encroachment call against Shaw.
Oh, no.
So that'll push the ball inside the 10. To the 8-yard line, gives Lorain a 1st and 5 from the 8. They can get a first down without a touchdown. The backfield is, we see down below us, all looking over at the Lorain High bench. Well, that's new to me. I've seen 3 guys signaling into play, so obviously 2 of them are false. And right up the middle goes Solomon in for the touchdown, his 2nd of the night, the 2nd for the Titans. They lead it 13-0 with 7:29 to go here in the first quarter. And I'll tell you what, guys, you mentioned earlier, let's talk about this Lorain offensive line, because They've opened those holes for Solomon. Tyler Fogo is the center, a senior at 210. Evan Rikovic, left guard, 270 senior. Shane Ramey Roland, we talked about him on the opening drive, 280 senior is the left tackle. Right guard, Sebastian Breeding, a senior at 270. And Isaiah Ray is the right tackle, 275 junior. Boy, they've got some big young men.
They do. They do.
And now the extra point attempt is up. It's good. And Lorain High's lead is 14 to nothing.
We'd like to thank the Northeast Ohio Buick GMC dealers and Joyce Buick GMC for supporting our school this year. Whether you're looking for a new GMC truck or a used Buick SUV, drop into Joyce Buick GMC and check out their inventory for a wide range of new and pre-owned vehicles. As they say, go Titans.
There we go. So as we mentioned earlier, Joe Bach's finale with Lorain City Schools, 23 years. And I think all three of us have worked with Joe since day one.
Yeah, Tom, you were doing wrestling,
right? I was doing wrestling way back in the day. Admiral King had that little little perch way up above the stands out there, sure.
They built that for us, I mean, for TV20.
Mm-hmm. That's almost as good as the nest for Joe Tate over at Keystone.
Yeah.
The nest that Tate built. The Lorain High to kick off. That one doesn't go into the end zone. Two Shaw guys bang into one another. And the loose ball is scooped up at about the 5-yard line. And with absolutely nowhere to go is Jamar Davis.
That's the problem with specialties and not enough time to practice, not enough people to practice with. Yeah.
Now, my debut with Joe Bach, we're on the old sports scene shows.
Yeah.
And much to my chagrin, Joe Bach still finds a way to get those out on Facebook and the YouTube channel. I mean, I look at him, I go, who is that young, skinny guy sitting there talking to Mitch Gillum and Dan Turtis and
T. King even?
T. King? Wow.
Yeah. Well, you got to tell these.
I mean, when your wife looks at it and goes, that's not you. Yeah, it is, Diane. Yes, it is.
Used to be.
So, yeah, Joe Bach, what an amazing run.
Oh, we did a game one night, Joe and I, and I'm not sure who the other announcer was. We sat under a tree at Cleveland Heights because there was a street light right there, and that was the only way we could see the rosters, and it started to rain, and we got dripped on the whole night.
Fumble on the play. It looked like that ball squirted out of there, and I think Shaw was able to fall on it.
There's a Cardinal on the ball. 35, Zaire Cheney on the recovery.
And again, Lorain High, certainly the prohibitive favorite tonight. It's coming in at 6-1. Shaw 0-6. And a very shorthanded Shaw team. But you know what? Give credit to these kids for Shaw that are playing and got on the bus and came over here tonight.
Absolutely.
And there's misdirection. And now we've got a lot of room on the left side in front of the Shaw bench and finally ripped down on a nice gainer for the Shaw Cardinals.
That's that little deception that you can see, and they got some athletes.
There was a block by Cheney. Blocked by a wide receiver here. You'll see it. He held this block forever.
Yeah,
there it is.
Might as well give him credit. Number 17, Dajon Black.
So Shaw digs themselves out of that hole as a nice run by Zaire Cheney.
Now here's that quad to the wide side. We'll see what happens.
Four to the right as Roscoe rolling right. Looks like he wants to throw. He does. And that one's complete.
I see a flag on the play. Got to be a hold.
Well.
In that area where you see holds.
Nope. Face mask on Lorain.
Ooh.
Now, that pass was completed to number 73, who we don't have on our roster, gentlemen, at least on the away numbers. Shaw sent two rosters, one for home numbers, one for away numbers. I don't have a 73 for the away numbers.
Yeah. I'm going to go to the cell phone roster here.
But as Jay said, that's a big infraction against Lorain High, as now Shaw for the first time tonight on the Lorain side of the 50. They're at the Titan 41-yard line, just under 6 minutes to go here in quarter number one. Picture perfect night for high school football. First down play as, again, Trayvon Roscoe out of that pistol. Pitch left and trying to dance outside and get some room. And hemmed in and finally dropped at about the 39-yard line is Trayvon Pinckney. So Pinckney gets four. And you know what? We mentioned give the kids credit who got on that bus and came over for Shaw. And let's say the same for the head coach, Reggie Smith, and assistant coaches, Savon Gibson, Aaron Crosby, Steve Thomas, Gary Fitz, Elijah Bibbs. I mean, they're working with these kids, and I'm sure it gets frustrating. And yet, as you guys know, sometimes as coaches, yeah, you have to battle through adversity and teach kids about these life lessons that, hey, it's not always going to be handed to you on a silver platter. You got to work, and you got to keep grinding at it, and that's what these Shaw kids are doing.
For some of these schools, it's not all about football.
That was an aggravated Coach Creel that called that timeout.
Tell you what, let's tell you about the Jim Popiel Foundation annual fundraiser. Now, that's coming up Sunday, October 29th. It's going to be held at the Shipyards. And, of course, that day the Browns take on Seattle. Now, the Jim Popiel Foundation annual fundraiser, doors open at 2:30, lunch from 3 to 4. Browns and Hawks will kick off at 4:05. There's going to be food, raffles, soda, a cash bar, $25 per person, and it's sponsored by the Lorain High Sports Booster Club. Tickets for the event are on sale now, right now, at the Lorain High Athletic Department. That's a very cool event.
It is. And all the money goes to scholarships.
There we go. Well, Tom, as you said, there's that four-receiver look to the right with one to the left. As Roscoe awaits the snap, he had Parks going in motion.
And there was contact.
Now another flag on the play. The officials all huddle together. That's never a good sign. I steal that from my broadcast partner with the Cavaliers, Jim Jones.
Yeah.
Jim, the officials are huddling. Tim, that's never a good sign. If they got to talk about it, it's not good. But the huddle breaks, and they're going to push Shaw back 5 yards to the 44-yard line. Of course, this will be my final high school football broadcast. Yeah, this fall, did a few games for WEOL and just thrilled to be here tonight for TV20. But this Cavalier broadcast right around the corner, our first preseason game will be Tuesday night. As now we have another timeout. The Cavaliers' first preseason contest Tuesday night down in Atlanta. And I can tell you guys and tell our viewers that everybody, top to bottom in the Cavs organization, really anxious to get back. Coming off a 51-win season and a playoff appearance, and for the young guys on the team, got that first taste of playoff basketball, and how different it tasted than regular season basketball. So everybody's ready to go. Everybody's excited about the upcoming year. Can't wait to get started. So off the timeout, Roscoe. Oh, he tried to pitch it. The ball came free. A mad scramble, I think.
I think he fell back on it, though.
Parks was able to fall on it. Boy, that play didn't look pretty from the get-go.
I don't know whether he expected him to come in front like a typical jet sweep, but he went behind him. I don't know if that was planned. What a hell. Whatever.
I think he turned the wrong way. I think he's expecting – or three stop. That's what happened. See, he was expecting to pitch that to the motion man.
Yeah.
That's what it was.
Like I said, put quads on one side and go weak side. Yeah, that's probably what, just a sweep.
Yeah.
Well, the thing is, when Shaw has executed and not shot themselves in the foot. They've had some big games. They've been able to do some things, but they just haven't been able to put it all together on a consistent basis. There it is. Now they want to throw it. They lob it over the middle, and it's incomplete.
And that's going to be real interesting because that was number 77 that had his hands on that ball. So
they did have someone way downfield open, but I don't think he could ever got the ball that far.
But he threw it to a lineman.
Right, he threw it to Alomar Stearns. I don't know if you can use the term intended receiver because he's a lineman.
Alomar Stearns, named after two great catchers. Sandy Alomar and John Stearns.
John Stearns with the New York Mets. Well, you're going back in time on that one, Jay Ferguson.
Yeah.
But Stearns was an outstanding catcher. How about this? Fourth and about a mile, fourth and 24, and Trayvon Roscoe.
Remember, they had 11-yard punt.
That's true.
So why not?
Roscoe under a rush, throws, tipped, and incomplete.
Thank goodness no one intercepted that.
Boy, for Lorain High coming up and making a diving attempt for the interception was Osir Kimball. Couldn't quite get his hands on it.
Now, Osir has four interceptions for the season, so he's up in the leaders of the county in interceptions.
So yeah, Lorain High, who has made easy work of the Shaw defense so far, takes over first down and 10. They're at the Cardinal 46-yard line. Lorain on the strength of two John Solomon touchdown runs, one on the very first offensive play of the game, a 65-yarder.
Right.
And then his second TD run, a shorter gallop of 8 yards. 14-0, Lorain. And
another timeout, Lorain.
Got another timeout taken by the Titans.
Is that ours again? Because the official on the far side called it first. So
I just assumed it was Lorain because they had one late guy coming onto the field.
So the ball will be at the 46-yard line. Well, the scoreboard right now is showing each team with two timeouts remaining.
Well, we've had three.
I was just going to say.
But the official on the far side pointed to his chest when he called that timeout. I don't know.
Equipment timeout, maybe? I don't know.
Well, equipment timeout should just be to get them off the field.
So here we go. Again, Lorain High has had their way offensively. Two touchdowns on two drives. Davis, pitch left. Solomon, look out, turns the corner.
Goodbye.
He's 25-20. Drag down from behind at about the 11-yard line. Boy, the one thing about Solomon, and we'll see it here on the replay, he's very patient, and man, is he smooth. Once he breaks into his stride, I mean, he is just running easily. It's almost like a racehorse coming down the stretch right here, and then he just turns it up a notch.
You know, nice stick-to-it-ness there by the Shaw defender.
Indeed, I agree. First down handoff gets Lorain down to about the 5-yard line as we're down to 3:45 to go here in quarter number one. So John Solomon, two touchdown runs. He now has 14 on the year. There's a handoff to Solomon. Make it three touchdown runs as he goes over from 5 yards out. That gives him 15 touchdowns on the season. He's gone well over 1,000 yards on the campaign with his duties tonight. And Lorain High now with a 20-0 lead.
I seen him limping a little bit, so I think we may have seen limited action from John for the rest of this game. Believe me, you want to save him for the next two, which are important.
If I had to put money on it, I think you just saw his last carry.
Might be.
Now the extra point attempt is up and good to make it a 21-0 Titan lead. 3:31 to go here in the first quarter of play. You know, Cleveland Clinic Sports Medicine is proud to be the official medical provider for Lorain Schools Athletics. Cleveland Clinic's team of sports medicine specialists deliver high-quality care to all athletes, from high school athletes to the Guardians and, yes, the Cleveland Cavaliers. Visit clevelandclinic.org/sportsmedicine. clevelandclinic.org/sportsmedicine to learn more. You know, one of the things that I was told is that for Joe Bach's finale tonight, after his 23-year run, there are all sorts of Club TV 20 alumni that have made this occasion tonight. So let me see if I can get at least some of these in and hopefully pronounce them correctly. Alexis Sexton, Amanda Hefka. Amanda's here. Brianna Nethers, Brittany Powell, Davion McGill, Dominique Bennett, Emmanuel Rivera, Hyatt Hernan. I didn't even recognize Hyatt.
I know.
Except for that 65-year-old Montreal Expos cap that he's wearing. I think they were wearing that when they were a double A team.
Yeah.
Look at that hat.
Right after the Royals left town.
He played with that thing in mud puddles when he was like 2 years old, and he's never gotten rid of it. But we'll go through the rest of the Club 20 alum that are here tonight. Just awesome. All to honor Joe Bach as the kick bounces into the end zone, and so Shaw will have it at the 20-yard line.
That's another plus from Reggie Johnson, is being able to put the ball in the end zone. I remember a few years ago they had to kick it out of bounds each play so the team couldn't return it.
Well, it's so often overlooked, that special teams aspect of the game, guys, and yet, as you well know, you get into playoff football, field position, extra points, everything magnifies come the month of November, and you've got to have strong special teams, and you better have a good kicker. So with 3:31 to go in the first quarter, and Lorain High with a commanding 21-0 lead, Shaw again will start at their own 20-yard line. Shaw tries a handoff to the right side, and Trayvon Pinckney tried to cut it back to the middle. Yeah. That didn't do him much good either as he got dropped at the 18-yard line. Make it second down and 12. What Shaw elects to do here, Tom, as you mentioned, they like that four receiver set either side of the field with the ball right here in the middle of the field. They've gone to the right side with the four and a single receiver to the left. As Roscoe now has room to the left, that opened up for him. Got to the 30 and he bounces out of bounds. I think he made the stick.
Yeah.
See, and that's what I'm saying. When they don't shoot themselves in the foot and when they don't make mental errors and they execute a play, they've done some good things tonight.
That's a very good play design out of that set.
Yeah.
You take the one receiver, run the cornerback deep, and there's nobody left.
Exactly. That's I called that. I knew that was what they're going to do.
And you've got an athlete at quarterback.
Boy, there's Troy Aikman, Tony Romo, and Tom Bauer. Yeah. Where's the telestrator? Tom, you could draw that one up.
Right, here it is.
Roscoe looks, throws over the middle. Oh, what a catch, and then spun down. I'll tell you what, that was a violent collision at the 35-yard line. And give credit.
He held on.
Shaw, the receiver, absolutely. Nice job by Trayron Axon, and he's only a sophomore. Well, he took a pretty good pop.
Twice.
And held on to that football. Boom.
And made a few yards after the catch.
Well, that was Jeremiah Lopez trying to run through him.
Didn't wrap. Second and five as we're down to a minute and a half to go here in the first quarter of play. Roscoe rolling right, heaves it near side, and a nice sliding catch. Ball was thrown low, but coming up to make the grab was Dejon Black, and he's only a freshman. So, again, head coach Reggie Smith just trying to get numbers and build this program. So you're seeing some sophomores, a few freshmen on that Shaw roster, and that was one of the ninth graders right there, but a nice grab by Dejon Black.
Yeah, they're not holding anybody back for the JV game. This is it.
Yeah. Down to a minute to go in the quarter. Shaw at their own 46, first down and 10. Trayvon Roscoe, now he is a senior. Gets the snap, floats it, complete, but that play immediately blown up. Wow, nice defensive play coming up and delivering the hit for Lorain High was Martise Herman, I believe.
Well, they put some heat on him. I don't know if it was a blitz or just the defensive lineman, but they put heat on the quarterback.
We'll make it second down and 10.
Well, that's the same heat they put on that they got burned with when he followed the wide receiver.
Yeah, exactly.
He got outside of him. You know, they are sending that uncovered linebacker.
Well, now Shaw goes to a two receiver set to the right, one to the left. We've got a wing right as Roscoe, with 5 seconds on the clock, does take the snap, looks, throws incomplete. He was trying to zip that one over the middle to Dejon Black, and that will end the first quarter of play. So with one period in the book, it's a 21-0 Lorain High lead.
Let's stay here, Tim.
All right. Because Tom Bauer is going to read something.
Lorain is not going to direct your attention near the 40-yard line. We're going to have a special recognition at this time. Tonight, we'd like to take a moment and recognize an icon in Lorain City Schools who is working his last event tonight as he enters retirement. Joe Bach has spent 23 hard-working years in Lorain City Schools. Joe has been honored with the Distinguished Service Award from the Lorain Sports Hall of Fame for volunteering his time and video production expertise for more than 20 years. Joe's dedication and hard work through video production and live streaming has brought the Lorain and Lorain City School story to millions of people and advanced our video production program into the 21st century. He has contributed more than 2,000 different videos and productions and facilitated the creation of LCS's YouTube channel that has more than 7,000 subscribers and videos that have been viewed by over 3 million times. Again, thanks so much to Joe Bach, a Lorain legend.
Well, how about that?
Now they're going to get run over.
Get off the field now.
Well, I wasn't aware of that. I don't know if Joe Bach was aware. It looks like he got caught by surprise, but how appropriate, because as we've talked about throughout the broadcast, what Joe has done for the community and for the kids here in Lorain is absolutely extraordinary, and certainly he deserves all the kudos and all the accolades that he will.
Diaz on the tackle for the Titans.
So hats off to Joe Bach as he gets recognized down on the field. And Joe, the ultimate pro, says, all right, now I got to run up the stairs. I got to get back behind the monitors and start directing. don't worry, Joe. We got things under control up here.
Joe, we're going to have you back for the dedication of the elevator.
And I'll be here to ride it, I'll tell you that. Oh, man. So that was very well done. And, again, it caught me by surprise. So, sorry, Tom. I went to throw you a read, not realizing they were doing something for Joe Bach.
I didn't know it either, but I got it right now here. Your Lorain School's athletic trainer, Tracy Menes, who worked closely with Cleveland Clinic sports medicine specialists to provide your student-athletes the best treatment and sport injuries. I don't know if they have a camera on Tracy down there, usually on the field sometimes.
Not yet. Well,
she might be tending to a player.
Yeah.
So.
Oh,
or she's.
I see her out there in pink.
Helping Joe Bach up the steps.
Wow. Now that's a live read right there. Hats off to Tracy as she carries Joe Bach to the press box.
In fact, we're going to change it.
You know,
we're going to call it the press Bach from now on. We're going to make it singular.
She's helped linemen, and now she's helped Joe Bach. Well, on another fourth down for Shaw, they're going to go for it. As very short-numbered here tonight, very short-handed. Roscoe under a rush, quick throw down to the 45, and it's complete, but it's short of the sticks. And again, that's the situation right there where Leonard Norman, the receiver, just has to know.
You have to read where you're going to go. Yeah, if it's a 10-yard pass, you need 11. You got to get 11.
Well, there was a jailbreak up front. The Titans took all three defensive linemen and moved them to the offense's left side. So there was pressure right up the middle.
So Lorain with that 21-0 lead. Well, we do see Solomon back on
the
field.
We do, yes.
Three touchdown runs in the first quarter of play. Puts him at 15 TDs on the year. He had a 65-yarder, an 8-yarder, and a 5-yarder. This drive starts at the 46. Here comes Solomon to the right. Tries to bounce outside. Gets to the midfield stripe and pushed out of bounds as he ends up on the track. And now a late flag. As Solomon got ridden down and then a little extracurricular activities here on the near side. So that'll put some more yardage on that.
And that'll bring Osir Kimball out into the formation.
Which is smart, yep.
So Osir Kimball, and his numbers are pretty good as well. He's a junior, not nearly the yardage of Solomon, but Osir, 360 yards coming into tonight at just under 7 yards per carry. And again, guys, that goes back to that offensive line, whether it's Solomon, whether it's Osir, Fogo, Rikovic, Breeding, Ray, and Ramey Rowland have done the job up front.
You know, what Osir has is a little more speed. He does. He's a little faster. He may not have that same through the middle of the line kind of things, but once he gets in the open, he may not be caught.
That line also tonight's missing Julius Manning, who's got a little bit of an injury problem they decided not to risk. So
he was always the starting right tackle, wasn't he?
Yeah.
So encroachment call against Shaw now makes it first and 5. Early second quarter. Been all Lorain tonight.
Let's see if they throw it to Hyro on a post here.
Hyro Williams, 5'10 junior. Quick throw right side as that one's completed to Noah Buchanan. And Buchanan immediately hit after making the catch, dropped it about the 12-yard line.
Now look who's coming back.
Now, the one thing that I don't have to say tonight that I've said for all these years on the radio side, going left to right, going right to left.
So this is north to south.
There you go. Although the wind is no factor tonight, so it doesn't matter which way you're going. And here comes Solomon. He's going to the 5 and knocked out. Close to the 5. He may be spotted at about the 6-yard line. John Solomon, what a weapon for the Titans in that backfield.
Well, I'll tell you, he's one of those guys, too. If you're going to want him to sit down, you're going to have to take his helmet from him.
And you want those kind of guys. Put me in, coach.
You know, John went through a sophomore year with a knee injury where he couldn't even dress for a game. Heard it in a scrimmage in August.
They give it to Solomon. He comes up the middle, and
they're going to put him at the 1.
Put him down just shy of the goal line. We'll make it 3rd and goal.
Three guys down there look like they're hearing music.
I love that.
Or landing a plane.
So Lorain High looking to add touchdown number 4, and Solomon walks in for the 4th touchdown for Lorain High, and it's touchdown number 4 for John to make it a 27-0 game with 10:19 to go here in half number 1. For Solomon, a 1-yard touchdown run. Well, you knew it was going to be a big night when Solomon on the very first offensive play of the game rumbled 65 yards for the score. And Shaw has not been able to stop him ever since.
Well, and that's another one.
The extra point is up, and it is good.
Into the middle of the band tailgate party.
One of the things that's unfortunate about the dwindling numbers at Shaw, the participation numbers, look over at the bleachers on the opposite side. The band is here, but it's not nearly the size it used to be. And boy, the Shaw Marching Band back in its heyday was one of the best, if not in Northeast Ohio, in the state. I mean, people would travel for miles to watch a Shaw High School performance.
They were in the parade at the opening of the Beijing Olympics.
I did not know that.
Yes. Yeah.
Wow. Well, then people would travel the world to see the Shaw. Hey, what are you doing this summer? I'm going to Beijing. Shaw's playing there.
Yeah.
You know, it's great athletes, but we're going to see that Shaw band. But they were just phenomenal. So hopefully they can get that number back up as well, because to watch Shaw put on a show, it was indeed a show. It was just incredible.
And that's their sound coming through our speakers.
Right.
The small but mighty Cardinal Band. And of interest to people locally, first quarter, Columbia 7-0 on top of Clearview in a big Lorain County Conference.
That's a huge showdown with the Raiders and the Clippers. I know my good friends at WEOL are there for that one. There's a bouncing kick into the end zone. And, Tom, to your point earlier, boy, Reggie tonight
has knocked everyone into
the end zone.
Yeah.
Now at 28-0, we're not that far away from the running clock. Now, normally that would start
halftime?
Right.
Starts at halftime?
Yes, in the second half.
Well, don't
Go ahead, Jay.
Don't be surprised if it starts early.
Right. If both coaches agree, hey, let's just start it now, you can start it early, as Jay just said. So, again, both coaches have to agree to that.
What that does is give especially the Titans, a lot of chances to get a lot of their younger kids in there. Because I don't think they have a JV game tomorrow, do they?
They do, but not against
Shaw. Okay, they have somebody else coming in.
You know, it's catch 22 because you don't want to get guys hurt, but you know Shaw needs to get guys reps too.
Right.
They don't have a JV game tomorrow. This is it.
Shaw starting at their own 20-yard line.
The best field position of the night.
As again, their quarterback is Trayvon Roscoe. Roscoe with a quick throw to the right. And out to about the 24-yard line before he got shoved out of bounds was Dejon Black.
Shaw has had a running clock in every game this year.
0-6 coming in, and Lorain High, just a glittering 6-1 mark. And as both Jay and Tom have mentioned, that Sandusky game came down to the final seconds. Lorain High easily could be 7-0.
Coming into tonight, Shaw had been outscored 301-6 on the season.
That's tough.
You know what that speaks to? That speaks to the character of the guys that are still coming out here and competing.
Yes, and that's what I mentioned earlier. And to head coach Reggie Smith, I mean, give them all sorts of credit. That can't be easy Monday through Thursday. Looking
well,
at film.
It can't be easy Monday morning going to school and hearing right. your classmates.
Right, yep. So as Jay said, it speaks to the character. That's a great way to put it. So now Shaw at the 40-yard line. As penalty against Lorain High pushes the ball out to the 40. They haven't gone back to that quad look.
I think they're,
I'm going to put a man in motion. Now Roscoe's going to keep it himself. And a bit of a crease.
Not a bad play.
Got out to the 40-yard line. Trayvon Roscoe, senior quarterback, with a gain of 4.
A little bit of a counter look.
Yeah, exactly. And as we're saying, not a bad play. Has
Shaw played Warrensville yet?
Next week.
Next week, okay.
And Lorain has Bedford next week?
Bedford?
Yep,
yeah.
Bedford, and then home with Maple Heights.
Now, Lorain has already made the playoffs. I mean, they're given.
Yes.
Now they're just jockeying for a position.
Well, they'd like to play a home game. That was one of their two goals at the beginning of the year, were win the conference and play a home playoff game. They're both still
very attainable.
Within reach.
Roscoe under a rush. Ooh, he eludes the rush, rolling to the left. Now he gets wrapped up and dropped. And the ball popped out, but I think they're going to say he was down. Yeah,
he
the
was.
Whistle blew. And now Roscoe a little slow to get up.
That was Lopez, wasn't it, Jeremiah Lopez?
I didn't see the tackle. We see it. Yeah. Yeah, everyone's giving him the high five.
Well, guys, we talked earlier about the fact that Lorain High, on a couple of occasions tonight, they really haven't wrapped up. And that
right.
happened
yeah.
on the initial hit with Roscoe, but it definitely didn't happen on that second hit.
Here comes a replay for it.
Ooh. Is that Sledge in there first? He had a strip sack and a score earlier this year.
Boy, that sack moves Shaw all the way back to the 29-yard line. 8.5 minutes yeah. to go in the half. Lorain High on the strength of 4 John Solomon touchdown runs, leads it 28-0. Titans looking to go to 7-1 on the year. Appear to be well on their way. Trayvon Roscoe awaits the snap. Roscoe under a rush, throws, almost picked off.
J.L. Diaz.
Well, I'll tell you what, J.L. Diaz, only a sophomore. He was reading the eyes.
Yeah. He did a nice job coming up. Watch him. Undercut the route.
But the intended receiver was Trayvon Pinckney. And a great job by J.L. Diaz. 5'10 sophomore, almost had himself a pick six. Down to 8 minutes to go in the half, and now Lorain High is going to get some fresh bodies out there defensively.
Well, it looks like they might
punt. They're assuming they're going to punt.
Although it looks like they've switched punters. As the first punt of the night went 11 yards. And now the second one's blocked. And it's going to take a backwards bounce.
Yeah.
Okay, someone's going to have to explain that to me. If the offensive guy picked it up.
I think once you punt, you become defense.
You give up the ball.
As soon as you put foot to ball, you now become the defense.
On a block.
On a block.
See, all these years I've done high school football, I've never seen that before.
No.
Okay. Well, here we go, and here comes Solomon back in the ball game. As Lorain High looking to add to their 28-0 lead with 7:52 to go in the first half. And again, the Titan quarterback is Chase Davis, 6 foot junior. Right side, Solomon leapfrogs a tackler, fighting.
Oh, it's still to the one.
Just shy of the goal line.
You know,
boy,
I think
Solomon looked like a high hurdler right there.
And I think he was on top of one of his linemen. I think he was laying on top of Tyler Fogo, reaching the ball over the goal line. And they are doing all they can to keep the clock moving. It's still stopped, though. The guy on the under the goalpost's arm is going to come off. He's going to unscrew his shoulder.
There's Solomon. There's touchdown number 5 for number 5.
That was a fancy little cut up the middle.
So we were talking earlier about the Jim Popiel fundraiser coming up. Where's Jim when we need him? What's the Lorain record for touchdowns in a single game? We've got John at 5 tonight.
I know that.
All right, well, then let's go to Jay.
It is 6, and it was 2 years ago at Shaw by Robert. Was it Gonzalez? He was the running back. He wore number three, and he had five rushing touchdowns and returned an interception for a touchdown. It was the only win of the year.
I don't remember that. Yeah.
All right.
Well, yep.
Was that the game that was
Jim's
in the rain?
Jim's proud of you for knowing that. Yep.
No, it was at Shaw. And with that win, the Titans earned a trip to Lakewood St. Ed's the following week for the playoffs.
Do you wish he had stuck at four?
Oh, it would.
Yeah, they were 1-9 that year.
And that was the one.
And made the playoffs.
So it's a 35-0 Lorain lead.
I'll tell you a funny story. The first game of the season, John Salmon was within 20 yards of the school record for rushing yards in a game. And Coach Creel didn't know it and took him out halfway through the third quarter. So they were walking to the bus that night, Coach Creel and his young son, and one of the assistant coaches who said to Coach Creel, he said, you know, John was 20 yards short of the school record tonight, and he didn't get it. And his son looked at Coach Creel and said, because of you.
And how old is the son? Tell him that, too.
10.
10-year-older.
Yeah. There you go.
Criticizing daddy.
Because of you.
There's yeah, we'll get used to it, Dad. Oh, that's great.
They're down there on the sidelines. He and that's Russell Creel and Jace Wilt down there about the 30-yard line. Oblivious to the fact that there's a game going on.
But you know what? You want to be here, and you want to be involved with the environment and being around, you know, the varsity football players. And
there is nothing better as a coach and a father than when your son wants to come to practice or a game with you. That meant so much to me coaching in Medina with my son coming down to all those practices.
That's cool. So a 35-0 Lorain lead. Let's see if Reggie can put another one in the end zone. Boy, he is. Well, no. Well, that's definitely not going to the end zone as he pooch kicked it.
I do not think that was an attempt to be an onside kick. No. I think it was the
pooch. So that'll put the ball to 43 for Shaw. Let's go through a few more of these Club TV 20 alumni that are here. Now, we mentioned Hyatt Hernan with his 65-year-old hat. But there are others that are here. Jaden Morales. Boy, Jaden's been around a long time. Liz Husky, McKenna Willis, Marquintez Graham, Monica Amador,
Spiridon.
Spiridon.
Spiridon Golgus, right?
Oh, I met Spiro. There yeah. he is. Where'd he go? Oh, he's right here. Spiro. Why don't they just put Spiro here? You know? Oh, the voice of the Cavaliers is coming in. Let's get him to butcher a name right on TV 20.
Hey, if you can do Giannis Antetokounmpo or whatever his name is.
And Zach Baraga. Very cool, man. All these kids and now young adults coming back as the pass is dropped on the near side.
He probably could have had some yards after catch, too.
But, you know, going back to the Club TV 20 alumni and what Joe Bach has done here with TV 20 and the kids. Think about the number of lives impacted that Joe was able to give hands-on experience in TV production and camera work. And just think about careers that will unfold.
You know, there was a story just on Facebook the other day. Parker Kapronica, who graduated a couple of years ago, just won a local Emmy down at Ohio U.
That's awesome. That's just incredible. Now, Parker is also going to get a nice award. He's going to be given Hyatt Hernan's hat. So he'll put that right next to the Emmy, saying, you too.
But I'm going to tell you something about that hat, Tim.
Please do.
That hat was clean the last time Hyatt got a haircut.
I hope Hyatt's hair was as well.
When I had Hyatt in school, in middle school, and he didn't comb his hair, it never got a haircut. He didn't want to discriminate against any of them, so he just let them do what they wanted.
Third down and 9 for Shaw. They're at the 44-yard line as the Cardinals trying to make something positive happen. And, boy, that's been tough sledding tonight.
Whoa.
Here comes the rush. Roscoe rolls right, throws incomplete. Boy, nice job by Roscoe. You have to give him credit because the heat was on. And he rolled right and threw the ball just a tad behind the intended receiver.
You know, if you're going to build a program from the bottom up, it's really nice to have a guy like Roscoe. I mean, he is out there. It's 35-0. He's a senior. They're 0-6, soon to be 0-7. And he's competing on every play and not giving up. And, you know, he's leading by example.
Yep. Have to agree with you there, Jay. Absolutely. So now it's fourth down and 10. And Shaw trailing 35-0.
No punt situation here.
Two receivers left, one to the right, ball just about in the middle. Roscoe looks, throws. Nice catch made at the 45. Down to the 35, breaking a tackle to the 30. And all the way down to close to the 20-yard line. After making that catch.
That was the nicest play Shaw put together so far.
Trying to pick up the number on that.
This is like looking at a bingo board. It's Leonard Norman, 28, I believe.
There we go. Yes, the Shaw roster is in alphabetical order by last name.
I thought they were cheesing me because Becca was here for a soccer game I did the other night, and she said she fixed it because she knew how I felt.
So let's see what Shaw can do here. First down and 10. They're at the Lorain 20. Here's Roscoe under a rush, and he won't elude it. Boy, there's a bevy of Titans there to drop him at the 25-yard line.
Cam Sledge, 58.
Yeah, the pocket just collapsed. I think Tremaine Suttle was there as well.
The whole defensive line just pushed everything back. They just, you know, are just controlling the line of scrimmage.
Second and 15 as Roscoe was dropped back at the 25-yard line. We're down to 5:18 to go, first half. All Lorain High. John Solomon with five first half touchdown runs. Low snap to Roscoe, scoops it up. And he got popped in that Shaw bench, and there's the flag. And now another one.
I seen a football come flying out of there, too, though.
I think this might be offsetting.
Boy, it looked like Shaw.
Looked like he might have got hit.
Retaliated a little bit, right, after Roscoe got hit. Roscoe, again, as he's been doing all night, eluding Lorain High defenders. Roscoe right there out of bounds. And there comes the little extracurricular. And then Roscoe with a bit of frustration. He threw the football.
That's not the kind of leadership I want to see from my man Roscoe.
Right. But again, you know,
I see the frustration.
Jay, you mentioned they've been outscored, what was it, 301-6.
Yeah.
You know, every game has been a clock running scenario. I'm sure there's frustration that builds.
But they go to practice, I guess, and
so now the officials, once again, having that huddle as they try to figure it all out.
The only reason for this would be if the clock were running.
How about the fact that Lorain School's TV20 is trying to get to 10,000 followers on Facebook? Now think about that. 10,000 followers. They're getting close. So get on Facebook, like Lorain School's TV20. And, of course, TV20 is the home of the best high school sports coverage in Northeast Ohio. It's the media of most school district events. It's an award-winning Titan news program that they carry. So get on Facebook, and let's get the crew at TV20 to 10,000 followers. Now, Joe, where are you at right now? 9,600?
Oh, you got people watching tonight. 400 people. I know there's 400 of you out there.
Just all you got to do is do a like, right?
Yeah, go on Facebook and just like TV20. And from what I understand, if they get to 10,000 tonight, Joe Box buying. That's what I hear. There's the incentive. And then we'll tell you where we're going. That's and you right. can all show up, all 400 of you that put us over the top.
Well, that turned into
Joe said that number just went to 12.
Oh, we've already got 12 followers.
No, 12,000.
That turned out to two unsportsmanlike conduct penalties on Shaw.
Wow.
Wow.
So they have to get to the 10.
How about that?
45. It's second and 45. Do you have a call for that, Tom?
Hell yeah, if you had a Mahler on the team.
If you had Hussein Bolt, yeah. Get it to him in the flat. Put him in space, as coaches like to say.
Oh, now a little bit of motion there somewhere.
But, Tom, you saw they went back to that quad look.
Yeah.
Four receiver set to the short side of the field. They like to do it to the short side.
Yes.
Run the cornerback on the wide side and just give Roscoe some room to run.
But Lorain has put someone over here in the slot. No one to cover, but his job is to stop stop that quarterback. He got a spy on the quarterback now. They didn't have that at the very beginning of the game.
So let's see if Shaw goes back to it again. Nope, not on this set.
They got a running back.
Now they're going to go.
Now they shift into it. So they've got four left, the wide side, as you can see it. One to the right. Here's Roscoe rolling to the right, looking. Now he's going to take off, and he's got room. 40, knocked out of bounds. He got a good chunk of it back, although he's still down over in that Shaw bench area. And Roscoe took a pretty good lick right there. As you can see, he's still down on all fours.
Yeah. You can he had the pink socks there. You can see.
So, again, Roscoe, as he's been apt to do throughout the ball game, eluding Lorain defenders. And
that's
got
a nice,
chopped down, yep.
Nice open field play.
But they're still tending to Roscoe. And, boy, this would spell trouble for Shaw. I'm not sure who their backup quarterback would be.
That was junior Joseph Gaines on that tackle.
Well, if it was only third and 30, he would have made a first down.
Right.
Well, he's got it into a manageable 25 now. He got almost half.
So they're tending to Roscoe over on that far sideline. You know, I was mentioning earlier my start with Joe Bock. Began all those years ago on Sports Scene. And we were talking about the four receiver set, and it was shown beautifully with the camera work here tonight. I remember a Sports Scene that I did with Tom Ilsisco when Tom, out of nowhere on a Friday night, unveiled the lonesome polecat. And I had him on Sports Scene the very next week. We had already scheduled it. So he literally, Tom brought over the game film, and I had him describe for the viewers the lonesome polecat, because I remember I was doing that game on the radio, and Tom hadn't told anybody it was coming out on game night. It was a secret. And now you talk about on a radio call trying to describe the lonesome polecat formation. And it's funny, I remember that. And I don't think I've ever seen it since. But it was one of the most.
Mike Akesy was the quarterback.
Lonesome polecat.
Yeah, that was 1995.
Was it?
Because I was coaching for Lorain, and I was scouting that game because they almost beat Elyria in that game with that lonesome polecat.
Well, Elyria didn't know how to defend
it. No,
you think I didn't know how to call it? Elyria didn't know how to defend it.
They almost beat Elyria that game, yeah.
Oh, I remember that.
Mm-hmm.
I was here that night.
But I'll never forget, I called Coach Ilsisco before the Sports Scene show to say, Tom, can you bring the game film over and we'll put it up on the screen so you can describe why it's legal and Of course, now we're talking about it, and folks are going, what in the world is the lonesome polecat? But basically, you spread everybody out on that line, correct? Yeah,
they had a center.
And a quarterback.
And Akasi was behind him 10 yards deep, and all the other nine people were 40 yards away on the line of scrimmage.
To each side sometimes.
Yeah, they had a dual double polecat.
If they split it, you didn't have the lonesome polecat. Then you had catfish up the middle.
Wow. But it's funny, I remember that vividly. And I remember when they came out in that on the radio side going, folks, I don't have a clue what I'm looking at right here. And I'm trying to describe it because, again, we don't have the monitors and TV 20. Oh, boy. All right, so Roscoe is still being tended to. In the meantime, Shaw will be facing 4th and 25. Again, Roscoe, as Jay alluded to, picked up a good chunk. And so it looks like now the quarterback is going to be Trayron Axon. And he's only a sophomore. And again, as we go through this Shaw roster, there's all sorts of sophomores and even a few freshmen trying to rebuild this program from the ground up. So they spot the ball at the 35-yard line.
The man on the yard marker got tired and laid it down.
Yeah. I'm not sure what the holdup here.
He was pretty close to the sideline, but they've gotten him.
Yeah, to the bench area.
Yeah.
So let's see what Trayron Axon can do. Well, we've got Lorain coach coming off.
Yeah, it's Coach Creel.
Yep, head coach Damian Creel, now in his third year. What a job he's done. And now on the handoff, roughed up and dropped at the 30-yard line.
He eluded the first tackler, but all of a sudden the pursuit caught up to him.
Yep. Was Jamarian Parks. So now it's fourth down. I think I had said earlier fourth down. This makes it fourth down. We got 21 to go.
That was a nice block. 28 kept his block for a long time. So I thought he eluded him, but actually he was getting blocked.
We're under 4 minutes to go here in quarter number two. Where these guys bumping into each other in the backfield, and there is absolutely nowhere to go for Parks.
I think they're tipping their plays, Tim. 10 guys are coming out of the huddle laughing, and one guy looks scared. So you know who the ball carries.
Right. Well, the ball will go over to Lorain High with 3.5 minutes to go here in the first half.
Look, when we're done, there's going to be 22 people in that pile. Don't they call that a scrum?
Scrum. A rugby scrum.
Not with pads and helmets.
You know, I've called a lot of sports. I've never called rugby.
You haven't lived till you've tried to do hockey.
I have tried hockey a couple of times. I marvel at hockey play-by-play guys.
Those guys are incredible.
Absolutely phenomenal.
There's Osier.
Handoff, and that's Osier Kimball. Kimball to the 45, to the 50. He's got room left sideline, tiptoeing the sideline, and finally out.
And no flags.
And Tom, you talked about that speed of Kimball.
But again,
he accelerates.
The patience of before he did.
He was following his blockers.
Set him up.
Yeah.
Who is the offensive line coach for Lorain? Because that offensive line is very efficient. I see a list of the assistant coaches, but not sure which one specifically handles the OL, because
I don't know,
they do a terrific job.
I think Sly Wortley's.
Sly's
one of the JV guys. You know who has added a lot to this team this year in terms of X's and O's is Mike Franklin, the former Sandusky head coach.
Well,
You know, there's some things as an official you can let go, but when the defensive line runs into the offensive line, you have to throw a flag.
You gotta call that one. And again, these games aren't easy for officials.
No.
I mean, because you're trying to let the guys play, have some sort of semblance of control, and yet you can't call every single thing.
You want to try and keep it fair.
Right. There's a quick pass over the middle.
Buchanan again.
Fighting Buchanan. Got down to about the 2-yard line.
He fumbled. Or did he?
You're going to calm down at about the 2. Defender thought he fumbled.
Noah Buchanan. A couple of receptions tonight. Jay, you mentioned bringing Mike Franklin on. You know, for a head coach, boy, it's always nice to have another head coach that you can bounce things off and not be intimidated by that. And
well, he actually picked up two because Dominique Goodwin, who was the head coach in Oberlin last year, is on his staff as well. Now, I don't know if he's listed, but he's working with the younger kids and, you know, middle school kids and ninth grade kids. I saw him before the game.
Well, how do you pronounce Scott's last name?
Wadley?
Wadley. I see
he's the defense.
I see his practice working with the big boys down there, so he's probably offense and defense or just strictly defense?
I think he's the defensive coordinator. Okay. And Morrow is the offensive coordinator.
Getting quite a bit of time before this ball is set. Now they finally put it down.
Is that John Salmon?
Yes.
No, that was Osier in there.
Oh, no, that's Osier.
Okay.
Yep. Yeah, that's number 2.
If you want him to get the record, you got to give him this one.
Either that or your 10-year-old's going to holler at you again.
That's right.
Here's Osier, and Osier's into the end zone.
And that's your fault, Dad.
And now we got some pushing and shoving.
See, now what you don't want.
Oh, no.
Because here's what happens in games like this. This game's out of hand, but disqualification puts you out for next week.
Right.
And there's another flag. There's one. A plethora of flags I've seen thrown out there.
And a lot. And there's the one we just saw in the replay.
Yeah.
50 had a hold of the back of the helmet, it looked like, of one of the Titans. There it is. See it?
And a face mask at the same time.
Okay, it is the face mask. He was locked up with Ray. Isaiah Ray.
Well, again, tempers flare as the two teams go back to their respective sides. And, Tom, as you said, you don't want to see things get out of control. And we mentioned the officials. That's a tough task down there because frustration's going to build on the Shaw side.
And I see Coach Creel out there
pulling
some people away, which that's the job of a coach. Keep your players away from the other team.
So with 1:31 to go in the first half, it's a 41-0 Lorain High lead. Week 8 here at George Daniel Field in Lorain. Week 9, and we'll see the Titans on the road.
Next Thursday, as a matter of fact.
At Bedford, that's a Thursday game.
Thursday game? Why is it Thursday? Did we figure that out? Is it going to be?
If I were the coach, I'd be really happy because Friday is NEOEA day school.
I used to hate that day.
Yep.
Yeah. Back in the day, we always had Admiral King on that day. Yeah.
Going back to the records, we talked about John Salmon, 5 touchdowns and so forth. And again, I'm not the Lorain historian. So when they look at Lorain and these current crop of Titans, is it compared to the previous Lorain? Is Admiral King included in there? How are they looking at records, by the way?
Well, it's just Lorain, the Lorain Titans.
Okay.
Yeah. I would guess somewhere in Jim Popeil's spare bedroom, there is a Lorain City Schools record book.
There you go. There you go. Okay.
Yeah. Jim's here at the game tonight.
Yes, he is.
Yeah.
Everybody's here for Joe Bach. I mean, who's not here? See Bruno sitting right down below us.
Yeah.
Although Bruno hasn't missed a sporting event in Lorain since.
Do you know?
Well, I don't know.
In 1951.
Probably Jim Thorpe played here at one point, and Bruno was here to see it.
In Lorain High Scimitar in 1951. This is the honest to God truth. I saw a picture. Bruno Rossitano was honored by his classmates as having the best nose.
Yeah. Well, how can you not beat Bruno's nose? I'd vote for that nose, too. The nose knows. Oh, the ever-present Bruno sitting right down below us.
You know what? I want to be just like Bruno when I'm 92.
It's amazing. It truly is amazing. He had an easier time coming up the steps than Bach did after that presentation at the 40-yard line.
And he did not have trainer Tracy to help him. Chase him, whatever you want to say. So now
we've had quite a lengthy delay here.
That was again, much ado about nothing, I'm guessing.
Tempers flared after that Lorain High touchdown that put him up 41-0.
And I do see John Solomon down on the sideline without a helmet.
That's smart. Yep.
Jay, as you said, maybe somebody took it from him. John, you're not going back in.
How about this? Here's a score for you. Two teams ahead of Lorain in the playoff hunt with 6:45 to go in the second quarter. Cleveland Heights 42, Medina 25.
Wow. I'd like to see Medina lose, yeah.
That's 67 points in a quarter and a half. Yeah. Okay, something that was a fake, I think. I'm not sure at all what happened there.
Well, I can guarantee if that was the score, Cleveland Heights scored on the ground most of their points, and Medina scored in the air most of their points. Yeah, just knowing the two teams.
Yeah.
But boy, where is Medina producing these quarterbacks from?
It's a system right now.
Wow. Yeah. I mean, Drew Aller at Penn State.
Danny Stoddard now. Yep. I mean, he's got Mr. Football-type numbers, along with the running back from Cleveland Heights.
I think it's Larry Laird, the coach at Medina.
Yes.
Oh, no,
that
no.
Got to be on.
Oh, no.
Extra point attempt is good, but again, got some roughhousing going on. And
this couple weeks in a row at home here where Reggie's gotten housed. Was it 2 weeks ago? They scored the second touchdown.
Take them into Lorain the locker
High.
Room.
Yeah. Yeah, well, the half has come.
Yeah.
So we are at the half, Lorain High.
Now, that touchdown was scored with 1 minute and 41 seconds. Didn't you have that written down?
Right, 131 I wrote down.
131, yep.
How did you lose a minute and 30 seconds?
Because I think they said we're going to start that running clock.
Yeah, I think that's right. It happened, yeah.
So we are at the half. It is a 42-0 Lorain High lead. John Solomon with 5 touchdown runs. And we'll see here Kimball with one right before the half to make it a 42-0 ball game. And so we will take a timeout. Is that how it works, Joe? Yes. Yeah, so we will take a timeout on WLCS-TV 20, Lorain City Schools Television. The drone.
Hey, students, this is the Cleveland Browns linebacker, Jeremiah Owusu-Koramoah. Make sure you start off school this year on the right foot by showing up every day on time and ready to learn. Let's stay committed, let's stay focused, and let's stay in the game.
Inspiring city and campus. Inspiring people. Inspiring creativity. Inspiring hands-on learning. Inspiring global experiences. Inspiring traditions. Be a Buckeye. Inspire.
Hey, students. This is Cleveland Browns offensive lineman Wyatt Teller. September is Attendance Awareness Month. Did you know that missing school can significantly decrease your chances of graduating high school? Stay in the game by showing up to school on time and ready to learn. The Browns are always behind you.
their speedsters on, they're going to rock this next song, even in their band uniforms. I bet you made them look.
Students, this is Cleveland Browns tight end Harrison Bryant. Forming good habits helps you now and in the future. Get to school every day and on time and ready to learn. Let's stay committed, stay focused, and stay in the game.
Ohio State is saving lives every day.
This is Ohio State.
We're the economic engine of the state.
A major employer.
Over 60,000 students.
We're on the forefront of cancer research.
An educational core of Ohio.
Impacting tens of thousands daily.
Our alumni organization is nearly 500,000 worldwide.
This is Ohio State.
This is Ohio State.
Ohio State.
This is the Ohio State University.
Every year, the Salvation Army serves nearly 30 million people in need. That's one person every second. So by the time you've finished watching this, 30 more lives will have been changed for good. All thanks to your donations.
Thank you.
Here we go. Start of the second half here at George Daniel Stadium in Lorain. Boy, what a great halftime show as the Shaw and Lorain High bands put on magnificent performances. So hats off to the folks in the band for Shaw and Lorain High. Two very, very well done shows. And speaking of performances, how about the performance of Lorain High in that first half with a 42-0 lead over Shaw? And, guys, we are going to have a second half that should take 24 minutes because we've been told the clock will not stop no matter what the circumstances. In fact, it's already running, and Lorain's not even on the field yet.
Well, yeah, I said to Brian Corey, I said, is this like AAU basketball? When you get up 5 points, you throw the ball out in the lobby?
Wow. So this second half is going to go by very quickly. So if you guys have anything to say, yep, get it in quick.
That's B-O-C-K.
Yes. Joe, can I tell the story as to how B-O-C-K came about? For those of you that didn't hear Joe in the background, he says, my story is a little bit different than Joe's. But my story is we were doing a sports scene, and I thanked the coach for being on and so forth, and I wrapped up the show, and Joe was early in his career at Lorain City Schools, TB20. Comes up, he says, hey, Tim, can you give me a thanks at the end? You know, can you give me a thanks? I said, oh, you'll get a thanks next time. And I must have said Joe Bach about five times and then started spelling it out. That's B-O-C-K. Joe goes, I think that was a little too strong. I said, no, Joe, you wanted a plug. You got your plug. Isn't that how you remember it, Joe? After 23 years, he's agreeable on anything. So the kickoff goes out of bounds, and again, we will have a running clock throughout this second
half. How much time is left without the ball being in play?
Ten minutes to go.
We went 2 minutes so far.
Yes. But as we mentioned at the outset, if you're just joining us, a big celebration tonight, not only for the guys on the football field with a 42-0 halftime lead, but Joe Bach's amazing run, just extraordinary work with Lorain Schools comes to its conclusion tonight, 23 years.
And, you know, Tim, the three of us know how primitive it was to look around this press box and see just what's been done here and back at the school for basketball. It's just incredible, the growth and the opportunities that students at Lorain High have as the result of this program.
Absolutely. And I've talked about that, as Shaw can't get the first playoff without a flag. But, you know, I've talked about that the hands-on experience that kids in Lorain are getting with top-notch digital professional equipment is simply extraordinary. I mean, I'm sure a lot of these kids go off to college and they're like, our stuff at Lorain was better than this because, as you said, it is state-of-the-art. And it is amazing what Joe has done technologically with the program here at Lorain. A quick hitter to the left side and bounced out of bounds is Dejon Black.
Well, I had my 11-year-old granddaughter over to Joe's office beginning of the year, and he was teaching her how to read off a teleprompter, and now she can't wait to get to high school so she can be in the video club.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah.
See, that's what it's about. It's exposing those kids to all the opportunities that are out there for them. And we mentioned earlier all the alums that are back tonight, and I'm sure there are several that weren't able to get here for whatever the reason may be that are exploring opportunities. And it doesn't necessarily even have to be in broadcasting. It can be in video production. It can be, you know, how, especially in today's world, you know, all the different avenues that are out there for video and audio. Although I'm begging all you youngsters, stay out of podcasts. Are there a billion podcasts now that are available? How do you choose your podcast? Oh, my goodness. Everybody's got a podcast. Quick hitter now to the right side. A little bit of room there, and that hole quickly closed down.
Yeah,
there was some room, and then not much for Black as he got thrown to the turf.
Yeah, there's some new names. That's a Ray Smith over there made the tackle. So.
Again, for Lorain with a 42-0 lead and a clock that will not stop here in quarters three and four. Now, they're going to get bodies out there to get them, as you mentioned earlier, Tom, game reps.
Yeah.
Get the feeling of what it's like to play under the lights on a Friday night.
Because they practice all week, just like the varsity, or just like the starters do. They deserve to get in some time.
Have we spotted the quarterback from Shaw, the starter on the?
I haven't seen his pink socks over there.
That's what I'm trying to find.
That's how I recognized him before.
Yeah, Trayvon Roscoe was knocked out of the ball game in the second quarter. He was the senior quarterback. And now they've got Jamarian Parks. He lofts one and making the catch, but getting dropped pretty quickly after making that reception was Jamar Davis. And he had the old, as Hank Stram used to say, holding that ball like a loaf of bread.
Yeah.
That was Hank Stram's line. Look at him.
Brandon Serrano, they got there for that tackle, 24.
Well, again, some new numbers out there for Lorain as they'll work to get guys in. And we mentioned this second half is going to go very quickly. We've already played half of the third quarter, and we've had three plays run.
You mentioned Hank Stram. Some people out there might remember Kurt Schumacher just passed away recently.
I saw that.
And he was drafted by Hank in New Orleans and told some stories about him, how he would take four suitcases to one away game because he was so vain he had to be dressed in three different suits
on the road trip.
Yeah.
Oh, that's great. Well, perhaps the greatest audio ever captured by NFL Films and the Sables.
Oh, my God.
Hank Stram, Super Bowl IV against the Minnesota Vikings. Matriculate the ball down the field, boys. Matriculate the ball down the field. Was it 69 cross-power trap? As the punt and a nice return. Ooh, big-time hit.
That was Serrano, wasn't it?
Yes.
I think he's going to get 15 more for the
Brandon Serrano, yes. I didn't see the hit, but it was.
Outstanding return by the sophomore, Brandon Serrano. And then he took a big lick right in front of that Shaw bench.
Now, if they work this right, we could be starting the fourth quarter here on this drive.
But that's the best punt Shaw got off. That was
right.
A nice.
Nice kick.
Nice long punt.
Some nice blocking there. Oops, there might have been a push.
Coming up and making that hit was Zaire Harris. But here's Lorain with an opportunity to add to their 42-0 lead. Again, running clock throughout the second half. So,
well, this is the primarily a freshman group here, Tim.
Leonard McCall is quarterback. And who's his running back?
I couldn't see.
Now, Leonard, saw him warming up. He's a left-hander, although I would doubt Coach Creel's going to put this ball in the air.
Is that Herman running the ball right now?
We'll find out when Steve Cawthon calls him for the touchdown.
There we go. That's a touchdown by Martise Herman.
And that's nice that Martise gets a chance to get it into the end zone.
I asked Jay a couple games ago, is Martise the fastest on the team? And he said, I'm mixing him up with his sister, because she was the track star. But he looked like he had some speed on that play.
Both of his sisters actually were very good track athletes.
So that makes it a 48-0 ball game. As again, an extra point attempt. Reggie's been perfect so far tonight. And you mentioned, Tom, earlier, that's a nice weapon to have as you get late into the season and into postseason. As once again, the extra point is up and it's good. Reggie Johnson, senior.
Well, one record for sure that has been broken or at least matched tonight is I believe that Davis goes to the bench with a perfect night in the air, 2 of 2.
Well, you're digging for records if you're going there, I'll tell you what. Hey, Cleveland Clinic Sports Medicine is proud to be the medical provider for Lorain Schools Athletics. Now, Cleveland Clinic's team of sports medicine specialists understand athletes. With many locations throughout Northeast Ohio, specialists can see your injured athlete for a same-day appointment. Call 877-440-TEAM. That's 877-440-TEAM, or visit clevelandclinic.org/sportsmedicine to learn more. So it's a 49-0 game as we're under 2 minutes to go in the third. And again, a lot of the folks have departed George Daniel Field already. And for those who are staying behind, this game will be over pretty quickly. Again, they're not stopping the clock for any reason whatsoever here in the second half of play. So this one will end in rapid-fire fashion. If you're just joining us, there's a line drive kick. Okay. It's one of the up men for Shaw at about the 10-yard line. And looking for some running room and not finding any is Leonard Norman.
Young guys are finding out that guys look bigger under the lights.
Yes. But if you're just joining us, again, it was going to be a big night for Lorain High right off the bat as they scored on the very first play of the game after having the kickoff out to the 35-yard line on the very first play of the night. John Solomon with the first of his five touchdowns as he raced 65 yards for a score. We were only 18 seconds in. Lorain had a 7-0 lead, and it just kept rolling for the Titans from that point forward. So we're down to 30 seconds to go here in the third. Shaw has it at their own 19-yard line. By the way, well, I'll get this comment in after the play. As, again, Shaw with the direct snap back to Jamarian Parks. And Parks stumbles forward to about the 16-yard line. I do have to apologize because throughout the first half, I was giving some incorrect Lorain High stats. So that's on me. I had was giving short numbers as far as John Salomon's season rushing totals and touchdown totals. I didn't realize that the stat sheet I had was off by a game. Well, obviously, Lorain High had some big numbers in their last game. So for those of you that are saying, hey, Tim, man, that's not what John's numbers were. That's not what Iro Williams' numbers were. Well, you are correct. So as you watch this, my bad on the first half numbers. They were one game off. Well, we are actually going to switch ends. We were wondering even about that, if we would switch ends. But once I think they get set, yeah, they're going to roll this clock, and we're going to be about 12 minutes from being done.
They're set, and they're winding it right now. That both teams are walking down to the 17-yard line. So here we go. Fourth quarter's up.
Guys, you two were talking at the half. Again, there's two more regular season games to be played, but all eyes suddenly start looking at computer rankings and Joe Idol and, who's jockeying where. And for Lorain High, there's a couple of very interesting scenarios that could unfold.
The two goals all year, win the conference and get a home playoff game, and those are both well within reach.
Lorain is sitting in position number 8, and you have to be in the top 8 to get a home playoff, so that's what they're hoping. Now, they haven't got a lot of secondary points because of some of the teams they're playing aren't doing. But the next two games, now we have to assume they're going to win the next two games, you know, because you just can't get into the playoffs without winning, you know, so that's important. But the next two games, they will get some second degree because of Bedford and Maple both have won some games.
Well, and your conference team, once you're in the conference, teams you've already beaten, somebody's going to win because they're playing one another. Now, if Shaw loses next week, well, we beat Warrensville.
Or Shaw wins next week and beats Warrensville. Yeah, you get points there, too.
I'm going to tell you one more time about the Jim Popiel Foundation annual fundraiser because I think this is a great event. It's Sunday, October 29th. It's going to take place at the Shipyards. And, of course, that's one of the great locations in Lorain. Browns play the Seahawks that day. Now, the doors will open at 2:30, and then lunch will start at 3, 3 until 4, and the Brown Seahawks kick off shortly after 4 o'clock. There's going to be food, raffles, soda, cash bar, $25 per person, sponsored by the Lorain High School Sports Booster Club. Tickets for this event are on sale right now. Go to the Lorain High Athletic Department. The foundation awarded $9,000 in scholarships to Lorain High student-athletes this past year. So October 29th, Browns and Seahawks down at the Shipyards and the Jim Popiel Foundation annual fundraiser. That's just great. That's
great
awesome.
Event. It is a great event.
You know, as we're watching this, I'm just wondering how much time Parks gets in practice taking snaps.
Right.
You know.
Yeah, for Shaw, I mean, not that they had an opportunity to, you know, come back or be competitive with Trayvon Roscoe, but Jay, to your point, he was a senior, and he was making some positive things happen when Shaw was being fundamentally sound and not committing mental errors and the like. But now you've got a young man back there in Parks, only a sophomore, and if you're short on guys all week in practice, as you just said, how many snaps is he getting?
I think this is Roscoe over here. Just put his jersey on right at about the 48-yard line as the punt was away and picked up.
And here we go. We've got a nice return down the left sideline. And breaking off a tackle and taking it to the house for the touchdown.
That is Brandon Serrano again. Well,
sure,
I see one flag.
Ooh.
And I thought I did see a block in the back. Yeah.
Yep. Brandon took it all the way back, but that one's going to come off the boards.
Who do the JVs play tomorrow, Jay? Do you know?
I don't know.
No. Well, here's the replay. I'll tell you what. If the penalty doesn't wipe it out, it's a beautiful punt return by Serrano.
The signal indicates that somebody gave someone else a hug.
Yeah.
And the job right here that Serrano does, well, there.
Picking the ball up on the bounce.
Right. Breaking off that tackle right there.
Getting away from the people on the track.
There you go. And, again, I just want to applaud because I know this last seven-plus minutes is going to fly by. Just applaud Damian Creel and the job he has done with this football program. As you guys both alluded to, he has brought structure and discipline and hard-hitting football. And, boy, the rewards are now showing. A 7-1 mark after the win tonight with two more games to go. It's a fun team to watch. Hats off to Coach Creel. I remember, again, going back to sports scene, and even the ones I did many, many years ago. I also did one a year or so ago with Coach Creel, and he actually got emotional during the sports scene shooting that, you know, he wanted to bring positive impact and have success with these kids in Lorain. And he got emotional, and he apologized. And I said, Coach, you have no need to apologize.
No.
When, you know, that shows the passion and the heart and how much you care about these kids.
And
it really came through.
And the kids know that.
Mm-hmm. Right. Absolutely. Kids know when coaches care about them. Absolutely. It's inside handoff, as I believe that was Manny Rosario.
Yep.
It was.
Rosario,
it was,
on
yes.
That carry.
You know, Tim, I can't remember who said it or where I first saw it, but, you know, a cliche around sports is before they care about what you know, they have to know that you care. And Damian Creel lives that.
No, he has just done an incredible job as Lorain High riding high as a record that will now go to 7-1. We're down to 5:45 to go.
I think Lorain has put Whitaker in at quarterback.
Whitaker. He's the sophomore.
He's the sophomore.
David?
Yep. He played one game against, was it Garfield or Willoughby South?
It was one of them, yeah. He filled in and Davis was unavailable.
And threw two touchdown passes, so Lorain has some people coming up.
David Whitaker, a big young man. They list him at 5'10", 220. Here he hands off to Allen. And Allen fights his way inside the 10 to about the 9-yard line. Well, that flag, which has been still all night long, is now starting to billow in the end zone to our left.
Blowing in from the west, and that's where the weather's coming from. They claim there might be some rain about 10 o'clock.
Boy, this running clock
be
is a
here.
Blessing.
Yeah.
This running clock is a blessing. And how apropos is it that Joe Bach, in his final game, gets the running clock? He's going to punch out early. How's that? Lorain with the football. Again, 49 to nothing. As there's some hard running right there. Gritty effort.
I didn't see who it was, but his feet never stopped. 15, is that
Rosario
again?
Yeah, Manny Rosario.
5'9 junior getting a chance.
I'll tell you what, when Brian Corey sent me the roster for tonight's game, I mean, look at the numbers. Look at the amount of kids that are playing football for Lorain High.
Yep.
Boy, how encouraging is that? Like, that's the key.
Absolutely it is.
As again, David Whitaker, now the quarterback. Left side and run out of bounds and tackled out of bounds.
And there's another one flag.
Yeah.
And definitely a late hit.
Some of these aren't real unsportsmanlike. They're just unnecessary roughness.
I
have a difference, and especially officiating so much wrestling. It's a difference between unsportsmanlike and unnecessary roughness. You know what I mean?
There was a pretty good face mask grab involved there.
So with Whitaker now in that pistol formation, the handoff and the touchdown goes to Manny Rosario. So Rosario makes it a 55 to nothing ball game. Again, clock won't stop. As Rosario goes over from 6 yards out. Well, John Solomon got it all started with 5 touchdown runs. Kimball then had a 3-yard touchdown run late in the first half to make it 42 to nothing. Herman with a 17-yard touchdown run in the third, and now Rosario with a 6-yard burst here in the fourth. It's been all Lorain High from the get-go. See if Reggie can stay. Botched it. Now they throw it for 2. Well, when you're having that kind of night.
I don't think that was planned.
No.
Rolled back.
Yeah, you always have a fire called when that things like that happen, and they executed their fire for perfect execution. 2-pointer.
Now, this is not Woody Hayes because I couldn't go for 3, by the way.
Yes. One of the great Woody Hayes lines. For those of you that are wondering, what is Jay Ferguson alluding to there? Of course, Ohio State and Michigan, the biggest rivalry in college football, and the Buckeyes just blasting Michigan. I'm trying to remember what year that game was.
1969.
It was
68 season.
Right. Yeah. Just annihilating the Wolverines, and Woody late in the game with the huge lead decides to go for 2. Converts the 2-point conversion, and after the game they ask Woody, why'd you go for 2 when you're up so huge? Because I couldn't go for 3.
And the next year, Michigan hired Bo Schembechler.
Yes. That may have been the greatest coaching rivalry in college football history.
Goodness, yes.
Bo and Woody. I mean, there's other rivalries, you know, Auburn, Alabama, and those type of things. But as far as coach against coach, Bo and Woody, and that 10-year war.
Wasn't there a story that Woody made someone push the car into Ohio because he refused to buy gas up in Michigan that stayed up north?
Yes. Well, this kickoff will probably do it. We're down to about 20 seconds to go.
Oh, my goodness.
as they have simply just let that clock run all the way down.
I don't think they're going to have to kick, are they?
Well, I don't know at what point they spotted the football, but I don't think the officials are going to call delay a game
the
here.
The kicker is talking to the coach, so I don't think they're planning on kicking.
Nope.
Well,
that's the game.
Going to do it.
Now,
wow.
One thing you want to coach kids right here in this situation, put your helmet on.
Yes. Well, the scoreboard reads 57-0 as Lorain High dominates a shorthanded Shaw team here at George Daniel Field tonight with the victory. Lorain is now 7-1 with two games to go in the regular season. Next week, they will be at Bedford. And again, for you Titan fans, that's a Thursday night game.
Yeah.
So kind of keep that in mind. Thursday night, Lorain and Bedford. And then the regular season finale, week 10, will be back here at George Daniel Field when Lorain takes on Maple Heights. But as Tom and Jay both alluded to, a playoff berth is a foregone conclusion. So there will be a week 11. But, of course, so we'll see how the next 2 weeks play out before we know more as far as where that game will be played and the like. But Lorain High, this outstanding campaign continues as they go to 7-1 on the year with a 57-0 drubbing of Shaw. And again, it was all started on the very first offensive play of the game. John Solomon with a 65-yard touchdown run, only 18 seconds off the clock. Lorain had a 7-0 lead, and not to bring you every score, Solomon would add two more touchdown runs in the first quarter. It was 21-0, Lorain High at the end of one. Solomon with two more touchdown runs in the second. Kimball had a touchdown run late in the second, made it 42-0 at the half. And that's when we learned it'll be a running clock in the second half of play, no matter what happens on that field. And, boy, they held true to that. 24 minutes of football took about 26 minutes to complete. But Lorain put two more scores on the board. Herman with a 17-yard touchdown run in the third. And Rosario with a 6-yard touchdown run late in the fourth. Turned out to be the last play of the football game. Well, actually, the extra point, Lorain High, maybe their only mistake of the night.
And they got two instead of one.
And they ended up with two on a two-point conversion pass. And that made our final 57-0 to push Lorain to 7-1 on the year. And, guys, before we wrap it up, again, Joe Box, incredible, remarkable, astounding, use whatever adjective you want to use. Run with Lorain City Schools comes to its conclusion tonight. I know all of us marvel at the work that Joe Bach did. You talk about a guy that worked overtime and then some to cover Lorain Schools and cover the city of Lorain like Joe Bach did. There'll be somebody to follow Joe Bach, but it's going to be like Tino. I don't know if you're going to replace Joe Bach because he just did an extraordinary job, and his presence in Lorain City Schools and in the city of Lorain made this school district better, and it made the city of Lorain better.
Very good, Tim.
It is.
And this is about Joe Bach, but I want to point out one more nice thing that Coach Creel has brought to Lorain with this season is the band and the team celebrate together
right
after every game.
Absolutely.
And the band parents actually fed the football team along with the band on Thursday night.
That's cool.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Unity is a great thing in a school. It is. Unity is what you aim for. So,
well, guys, as I said, I was honored to be here tonight, to be a part of Joe Box finale and to watch this Lorain High team, which I had not had the opportunity to see throughout the season, but certainly have been following their success and their exploits on the gridiron. This was just awesome. I appreciate it so much. And Joe Bach, I don't know when our paths will cross again. Who knows when we'll see each other. Although I hear he has a palace, like a palace in South Carolina. You know, the NBA All-Star break, late February. Yeah, the son of South Carolina sounds pretty good late February.
They're called mansions down there. They're not palaces, yeah.
But, I was honored to be here, and great to work with you, too. Just
always
awesome.
Always a pleasure,
Tim. For here, Tim, for sure. We'll see you for sure in May.
Yes.
Yeah.
But whose camera will I be looking into? You know, I usually, when I'm up at the podium at the Hall of Fame, I'm looking into Joe Bach.
He'll be there. He always has done this for the last I don't know how many years.
Well, 23.
And he'll be there again this year too.
He didn't retire from that.
No. Nope.
There we go. Well, again, Joe, congratulations. Just an incredible career, an amazing run with Lorain City Schools. I know I speak on behalf of this entire community when we say thank you. Thank you for a job well done. Guys, thanks to you. Of course, thanks to everybody on staff at TV 20, Lorain City Schools Television. Biggest thanks, of course, goes to you, the viewers. Hope you enjoyed it. Again, it was all Lorain tonight, 57-0, as they demolish Shaw High School here at George Daniel Field. So for Jay Ferguson and Tom Bauer, I'm Tim Elkhorn saying, once again, thank you so much for watching. And so long, everybody.